mama, give me that good. Cause I'm the fire man, you hit a fire truck. On campus, it's the Birdman Jr. Money too long, teachers put away the rulers. Fraud tune, not a cartoon. No shirt, tattoos, and some war wounds. I'm hot, but the car cool. She wet, that's a carpool. Been in that water since a young and you just shark food. Quit drama, crawl.
How y'all doing today? It's your boy Blizzo Brasco, baby. All right, man, check it out, man. So, took a little break from the gameplay, as you could see in that intro clip. I'm loving the fire break. Purify it. That shit is so dope. Burning motherfuckers to a crisp with their crispy asses. Anyways, man, so I'm a little late with this little update with the Call of Duty points and whatnot. So, I'm going to talk about the Call of Duty points and the supply drop system, what I like about it, what I don't like about it, and my overall feedback on the system as a whole. Just real quick, briefly. Before I do that, y'all already know the deal. I'm watching you. Subscribe to my channel. You are being hypnotized. Subscribe to the channel. For real, man. Subscribe to my channel, man. Don't forget to like and leave your comments below. Anyways, man, so just real quick, you know, most of y'all already know the supply drop system in the game. Basically, you earn crypto keys for every match that you complete. And those crypto keys is currency that can be used to buy supply drops from the black market with the little Cuban, Asian, whatever he is that's sipping on his gin and juice up in that little crack whore apartment. Bullshit. Anyways, man, so the things that I like about the system thus far is that it is strictly cosmetic. Well, up until the patch, it was strictly cosmetic. It was nothing but camos, different good game gestures, different threats and stuff like that. You know, after the game when they showed the top three or whatever. So it was good in that sense. It was all cosmetic. They gave you different emblems that you could use for your little icon or whatever that you create. Damn. You know what? I'm gonna keep on recording. I'm not gonna edit that shit out. God damn it, y'all just gonna have to deal with it. So, hey, up until the patch, it was strictly cosmetic. They did add some weapons in there, brass knuckles, a butterfly knife, and a wrench or some shit. Still, nothing that's gonna give nobody an advantage over anybody else. So, I do like the fact that it's strictly cosmetic. I like the fact that you can earn the crypto keys at a relatively decent rate to be able to purchase supply drops. And also, not gonna lie, you know, the addition of the Call of Duty points, I won't be purchasing none of them shits because, you know, your boy's balling broke, which means I'm balling on a budget, baby. But I do like the fact that if you want to purchase them, you can. You can purchase Call of Duty points and you can use them Call of Duty points to buy supply drops. Just that's something you want to do. Hey, do the damn thing. Don't let nobody tell you don't do it or whatever. Or you're a sellout if you do it or any type of shit like that, man. It's your fucking money. Spend it on whatever you want to spend it on. So if you want to buy them shits, buy them shits. Now, I like that they give you the option to buy it. Here's what I don't like. Ever since before the patch, it was more sensible to buy common supply drops. Because everybody was having better luck with the common supply drops getting better shit than you were out of the rare supply drops, which are 30 crypto keys. Common supply drops are 10. After the patch, I haven't been getting any good items out of common supply drops, which is leading me to believe that they're pushing you more towards buying the rares. The more rares you buy, the less crypto keys you're going to have, which means they want you to buy them Call of Duty points so you can buy more rare supply drops. It's all about money, man. Remember that shit. It's all about the money. And that's what they're pushing you to do. I think that patch made it to where the common supply jobs wasn't so common to get no legendary, no epic, and rare items no more. But hey, that's just my personal opinion. That's something I don't like. Another thing I don't like, with the addition of these melee weapons, okay, they're not going to put you at an advantage now, but I'm afraid that if there's a success with this adding this to the supply jobs and more people buy Call of Duty points, that when it's time for DLC weapons, there are going to be some weapons in these supply drops that are slightly OP compared to the ones that are already in the game. And that scares me a little bit. Because I don't want this turn into no pay-to-win bullshit like Advanced Warfare where everybody had to get the Speakeasy or the motherfucking Inferno Battle 27 to be at an advantage over their opponent. We don't want that, Treyarch. So don't fucking do it. You hear me? Don't do it. Anyways, man. Overall, like I said, the system, I'm happy with it thus far. I don't know how it's going to be with this new little patch, this new little update. We're just going to have to wait and see. And hopefully, there won't be any more major changes that are going to be for the worse for some of us who just don't spend a whole lot of money on DLC. But anyways, let me know down in the comments. You can type it. You can text it. Whatever the fuck you want to do. How you feel about this shit? How do you feel about Call of Duty points? How do you feel about the supply drop system and the crypto keys? Let me know what you think down in the comments. Like the video if you enjoy the content. And if you are not subscribed to the Blizzard Brasco Gaming channel, please do so at this time. And I'm going to see y'all in the next video. Peace.